Good morning once again, everyone. This is Tube 87. And to those who are still keeping the Sabbath, I hope you're having a peaceful and blessed Sabbath. Now, my second video this morning is going to be on communication. Someone asked me if I could do a video about communication because they were having some struggle with it, as most people do. And so I'm going to expound upon that a little bit and try and be as simple and clear as to a couple things that can easily change your ability to communicate or have people understand what you're trying to communicate with them and deal with people at the same time. So with that, let's go with this. Your communication is based on a foundation. Irregardless of what you think, your communication is based on a foundation. Either you stand on the foundation of something that's spiritual, or you base your communication is based on something of the world. Now, what I mean by that is individuals who have a spiritual foundation, I'm going to say as I do, I stand by the Heavenly Father in His Word. I communicate, live, eat, sleep, breathe based on that. Now, the upside to having a spiritual foundation is that you're basing your life, everything about your life, the way you live, the way you communicate, the way you eat, sleep, and drink, you're basing that on something that is perpetual, something that is never changing, core values that never change. It is what it is. Now, quickly over to the other side, if you're living based on the values and standards of the world, you're basing your foundation on something that's always shifting, always changing, different from minute to minute. So your ability to communicate with others and even receive communication is always shifting and changing because you have no permanent reference point. Remember, if you have a spiritual foundation, everything you do, you refer to a specific thing, and that is you refer to the Heavenly Father. I'll give you an example. If someone came up to me right now and asked me to do something, it could even be in the workplace or it could be family member, it doesn't matter. If someone asked me to do something, automatically my reference is always to the Father, His will, His laws, His standards, what He expects of us, and then I can easily proceed based on that. When someone has a foundation of the world, the same thing could happen. Someone could come ask you to do something, and there's always a pause, at least in your mind. You thinking about several things. Well, do I feel like it? Well, you know, it's not so right, maybe. Well, I don't know. See, your brain goes through a thousand different things because you don't automatically go, okay, well, yeah, that's the right thing to do. See, I can easily say, oh, yeah, that's the right thing to do, without a doubt. Or I can say no, because I have the answer to the Father. See, when your standard is the world and its foundation, its values and everything, all that is flexible. Don't stand on a flexible foundation. It makes communication difficult. See, I can stand on the Father's foundation and I don't care what it may or may not cost me in terms of how man views me. People are going to know that, well, you know, you're dealing with Lloyd here. He ain't going to go for that. He ain't going to do that. As Joseph said, on pain of death, it doesn't matter because ultimately I have to answer to the Heavenly Father. Now, when you're basing your standards and everything according to what the world asks and wants in its flexibility and constant changing, it makes communicating and everything else difficult. Now, And Matthew 6:24 tells us we cannot serve two masters. We cannot serve Yahweh and the world, to be simple about it. You either serve one or the other. And this is in every aspect of how you live. You can't blend the two. If you're blending the two, you're living according to the world, because the Father is having nothing to do with that mixing thing. He does not entertain that. So you deceive yourself when you weigh things based on, well, I really shouldn't do this because it's not the right thing to do. Well, if it's not the right thing to do, you shouldn't even be questioning. Don't do it. But don't weigh things before you do them. You already know if you're living according to the Father and his law. Now, you have your two choices of your foundation. Like I said, in the Word or in the world. In the Word or in the world. Add a letter. There you go. Those are your two foundations. Now, the reason people struggle with it, I say, and I've said, is because you're deferring to too many things and too many situations of the world. You're basing it on too many possibilities, the changing rules, the changing standards, the changing values of the world. Stand on the Heavenly Father's word, his will, his law, and all these things, which are permanent. They'll stay etched in, so you'll never have pause to answer or do. You already know. And ultimately, you have to answer to him. Stand for something and believe what you stand for. That way, it truly minimizes and, if not, eliminates your struggle. You can easily say yes and no to things based on that core you've put in you. Don't stand on something that's always shifting. If your foundation is shifting like the sands of the world, then it's always going to be a struggle. Things change too much. There's nothing solid there. Look, go with me to 1 Timothy 6, verse 17. It says, "Charge them that are rich in the world that they be not high-minded, nor trust in uncertain riches, but in the living God who giveth us richly all things to enjoy." 18. "They that do good, that be rich in good works, ready to distribute, willing to communicate." Verse 19, "laying up in store for themselves a good foundation against the time to come, that they may lay hold on eternal life." Couple of scriptures right there. It says that, charge them that are rich in this world that they not be high-minded. So, see, the Father gives us all our riches. He says, but don't become high-minded. Don't get caught up in that. Don't become arrogant with that. Okay, go with me to Galatians 1:10 and take notice to what it says. Galatians 1:10, it reads, it says, "For do I now persuade men or God, or do I seek to please men? For if I yet please men, I should not be the servant of Christ." So, you know, what that scripture is telling us is, you know, who am I trying to please here? You know, if I'm trying to please man, then I'm not being a servant of the Father. So we have to make our choice here. If we want to cater to the world and everything, cater to the world, because you're not going to please the Father. So make a choice. Put yourself on a solid foundation to be able to communicate. Forget pleasing man. We're not always going to please men. This is why people struggle with things like communication and getting along with other people, because there's always going to be conflict, because people want to be satisfied. People want to be pleased. Forget all that. Please the Father. Stand on his standards. Make people recognize and see you as to who you should be. Make them recognize you before they even come to you. Make them say, well, I ain't gonna mess with him because he ain't gonna go for it. Make people already know you're not gonna go for certain things or stand for certain things, because they understand and you've always been clear as to what you stand for, what you believe. And that's something spiritual. That's something of the Heavenly Father. People will leave you alone because the devil doesn't want to mess with that. But if you don't have that foundation, you're always gonna be confronted with things of conflict. And that's always going to affect the way you're able to communicate because you don't have a solid way to communicate. Now, go with me to 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 17. And it reads, it says, "Charge them that are rich in this world that they be not high-minded, nor trust in uncertain riches, but in the living God who giveth us richly all things to enjoy." Verse 18, "That they do good, that they be rich in good works, ready to distribute, willing to communicate." In verse 19, "Laying up in store for themselves a good foundation against the time to come, that they may lay hold on eternal life." So even in the Word, it talks about the ability to be able to communicate. And it says that you have to have a good foundation in the Word. And it also tells us that anything that we're given that makes us rich in this world, be it things, money, abilities, or what have you, it says, be ready to do good with them. It says, but don't trust in them because they're uncertain riches. He gives them, he can take them away. So don't get caught up. Communication is always going to be an issue, but there's no need to struggle with it if you have a solid foundation. You have to have a strong spiritual foundation, because there in that foundation are core values and laws and things that govern you permanently. It doesn't change. Come away from letting the world be your foundation and let the Father be your foundation. That way you can deal with anything of the world, because you will learn how to become humble. The Father will tell you when, or the Spirit will tell you when, to shut your mouth and just listen. The Spirit will guide you in things to say. The Spirit will change everything about you inwardly, so that things of the world don't have such an effect on you. So my answer to the question of being able to communicate better is, change the foundation which you stand on and cleave to that foundation, the spiritual foundation of the Father, and you'll be able to deal with people of the world and things of the world, because that's always going to be a challenge, because it's ultimately governed by the enemy himself, to keep all this conflict and stuff going, keep you off balance and keep you in conflict in your own mind and heart. It's a distraction. So anyway, with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is Tube 87. I'm out.